next on Soapography. Nancy Lee Gron. She's General Hospital's tough-talking attorney, Alexis Davis.
She's a pretty good broad, actually.
In real life, Nancy credits much of her success to an extraordinary mentor.
And my father believed that any woman can do anything that any man did.
Next, Nancy shares the inspiring and emotional story of her father's love and her loss.
My father died of emphysema in November of 2001. You're never prepared when it happens.
And she'll reveal how her father's memory has inspired her on set and at home.
My dad is my guardian angel.
General Hospital's sexy, tough-talking attorney, Alexis Davis, played by Nancy Lee Gron, is smart.
I wish I were as brilliant as she is.
Slick.
Yes.
And anything but stable.
She's feisty, and if you piss her off, you should probably walk away from her. She's complicated, which is why I like playing this character, because she isn't ordinary.
And neither is Nancy Lee Gron. She has a reputation for speaking her mind on the set.
I think they all like me, but I'm definitely trouble with a capital T.
But she's achieved success with a capital S. An Emmy, a beautiful daughter, and a no-holds-barred political agenda are what make Nancy, Nancy. In spite of it all, this superstar isn't about to take credit for her stardom.
My parents, obviously, are the most significant players in, I think, probably whatever successes I've had in my life.
Nancy was born in the Chicago suburb of Skokie, Illinois. Nancy and her sisters, Susie and Wendy, shared a tremendous bond with each other growing up. Their closeness has only gotten stronger over the years.
I'm very proud of the women in my family.
She was a cheerleader and homecoming queen in high school. It was there she also discovered her love of acting. Her parents encouraged her to pursue her dream.
My father believed that any woman can do anything that any man did. And so did my mother, and my mother did. She was a publisher, very smart, very successful. But her first role was always as a mother, no matter what. My father, no matter what he did, his first role was as a father. There was nothing, no phone call, no nothing that would take precedence over their children.
In spite of her family's close bond, Nancy's father battled alcoholism. It was a fight he would ultimately win.
My father was a recovering alcoholic. He was sober 25 years and was one of the success stories that's very rare with alcoholics.
While her dad conquered alcoholism, Nancy developed her dreams.
I was in high school and I was doing Bye Bye Birdie and I was singing and there was a spotlight and I was doing something and I just went, I felt what I believe now connection means, where everything was working the way that it was supposed to work and that I felt pure joy.
And so when a teenage Nancy announced her plans to forgo college and set out to achieve her dream, her father and her mother were behind her 100%. She did stage work in nearby Chicago. Her first role was a chorus girl in Guys and Dolls.
They're responsible for the road that I went down in life. I followed my dream. Those parents wouldn't say go for it, and they said go for it because they believed in me.
But Nancy wanted more. She decided to head to New York. While there, she attended school to learn more about her craft and did industrials to pay her way. Money was tight, but life was good. Nancy worked enough to afford a no-frills trip to the south of France.
They're just beautiful little towns, little villages. And so we go to this place, Les Baux, and we pull up, and across the street was this place called the Beaumonier, and this is a very famous, wonderful spot where Wolfgang Puck trained as a chef, and all the great chefs have cooked there, and it's quite a wonderful place to stay. We look and we have our noses pressed against the window. It's $100 a person to eat there, and you know, that was certainly not in our budget. So I just looked in there saying, one day I'll be back, and one day I'm gonna go in there.
Inspired by her travels and determined to hit it big, Nancy returned to New York. She quickly landed her first TV role, Beverly Wilkes on One Life to Live. 2 years later, she moved to LA, landing guest spots on major primetime shows like Magnum PI and Murder, She Wrote. She also hit the talk show circuit, where she and her dad used his illness to help others.
My father and I turned it around and we did talk shows about it and talked about the repercussions and how a child feels.
And then in 1985, she broke through with a big role as super attorney Julia Wainwright on Santa Barbara. To celebrate, Nancy returned to France in style.
We got on a train first class to stay at the Beau Monnier. And the best part was the chef comes out and he would say every night, he goes, "What can I make you to eat?" And I was like, and then he brings out their book, where every famous person in the world has signed this book. And he opens up a page, he goes, "I've saved this page for you." And on the other page is Paul McCartney.
Nancy Lee Grand knew she had arrived.
This is like a princess story. This is like a manifestation of that it's not just a fairy tale, that these things can happen.
But the fairy tale wasn't over. In 1989, with her parents by her side, Nancy took home the Emmy for Best Supporting Actress.
Winning the Emmy was another touchstone moment, where you just see a dream realized.
But in 1993, Santa Barbara was canceled. After a three-year break, Nancy landed a role on General Hospital.
When General Hospital called, I had been visualizing that. I decided I wanted to go back on a soap and I wanted it to be General Hospital. So this is another one of those touchstone moments.
An Emmy, a thriving career, a close family, and a father she adored. A seemingly picture-perfect life. There was only one thing missing.
Most profound dream I ever had is Kate.
Nancy wanted to be a mom.
I used to write her name in the sand before she, you know, was here. And I used to write Catherine Grace Lee Grand. I don't know, you know. I mean, I didn't know how I was going to have her or what.
In 1998, Nancy's dream came true. Catherine Grace Lee Grand was born.
When she was born, I had love from everywhere. There were 25 people in the room. It was different, I think, because I was, you know, a single mom. There is nothing that can compare to this. This was literally like being kissed from God. I describe her as heaven on a stick, because there is nothing that I could love more than her. Nothing.
And nothing Nancy enjoyed more than watching her daughter bond with her beloved dad. Everything seemed perfect, but everything was about to change. We've got more of Nancy Lee Grand coming up, but first, it's time for Soapography's Star Quiz. Nancy's most prized possession is her daughter's first lock of hair, her grandmother's engagement ring, or her 1966 Mustang convertible. Coming up next,
I just remember whispering in his ear going, "Fly, Daddy, fly."
Nancy loses her beloved father.
You're never prepared when it happens.
But gains a guardian angel.
I feel his love just as much in his having moved on, because now I feel like he's around all the time.
Soapography. So, what is Nancy's most prized possession? Her grandmother's engagement ring. Nancy says she wears it every day to remind her of her role model, the woman she affectionately calls her Nana. By 2001, Nancy Lee Grand was a woman who had it all. A veteran of the soaps, playing Alexis Davis on General Hospital had made her more confident than ever. She had an Emmy on her mantle, the daughter she'd always dreamed of, and a close, supportive family. Then came a devastating loss.
My father died of emphysema in November of 2001. That's a pretty icky disease. I just remember whispering in his ear going, "Fly, Daddy, fly," you know? And I knew he'd be okay. I just knew he'd be okay.
Suddenly, the man she'd always leaned on for strength and inspiration was gone.
You kind of know, you can prepare yourself and know that it's going to end at some point because it's progressive and it gets worse. But, you know, you're never prepared when it happens.
She mourned for herself and for her three-year-old daughter who lost a doting grandfather.
She was very close with my dad. My dad, you know, was there with her and always for, you know, lots and lots of time. Has had a very profound influence on her life.
And now, Nancy and Kate believe in their hearts that they have their very own guardian angel.
I feel his love just as much in his having moved on than I did, even more so, because now I feel like he's around all the time. My dad is my guardian angel.
Nancy makes it a top priority to keep his memory alive for her little girl.
So what we do is on Father's Day, on birthdays, on any special thing, we write little, we love you, Bobby, or I love you, or Kate says, could you send me a Barbie? Or, you know, she thinks he's Santa Claus in the sky, and we send him up. It's fun.
Nancy's using her fame to fuel her other big passion, politics. She's a major organizer for the Hollywood political community.
There are specific issues that really matter to me. I felt like I had to fight for my family, you know, because I've been an advocate for women all my life.
Nancy Lee Grahn is a confident woman proud of the life she's made for herself. And in the end, she credits her parents for it all.
They have instilled in me their, it's this heirloom they pass of love in this way that they did it that is so unique and special.
A gift Nancy can now pass on to Kate. A thriving career, a dream come true daughter, a supportive family, and a guardian angel watching over her, all part of the real life script for Nancy Lee Grahn.